We want to approximate the area under the function f of x equals 4 divided by x on the closed interval from 1 to 5 using 4 right-sided rectangles. So we just did this problem using 4 left-sided rectangles, and now we'll see how it's different when using right-sided rectangles. So we'll start by marking off the interval from 1 to 5. So we'll start here and end here, and then we'll divide this interval into 4 equal intervals. So we'll divide it in half, and then in half again. We know we need 4 intervals because there are 4 rectangles. And now to determine the height of each rectangle, we'll use the right side of each interval. So for this first interval, we'll use f of 2 as the height. So the height would be here. And then for the second interval, the height would be f of 3. For the third interval, the height would be f of 4. And for the fourth interval, the height would be f of 5. And notice how all of the widths are equal to 1. We can visually see the area of these 4 rectangles would be less than the actual area under the blue function, so this is often called the lower sum of the rectangles. So we'll label this the area of rectangle 1, area sub 2, area sub 3, and area sub 4. So the idea here is the area under the function will be approximately equal to the sum of the area of these 4 rectangles, so a sub 1 plus a sub 2 plus a sub 3 plus a sub 4. Now this notation here might look confusing, but it's basically saying the same thing. The area under the function is approximately equal to the sum of f of c sub I times delta x, where f of c would be the height of the rectangle and delta x would be the width. And in this case, there would be n rectangles. And then there's a formula here to determine delta x, where the interval would be from a to b, and n is a number of rectangles, so delta x would be b minus a divided by n if we have equal intervals. So let's go ahead and set this one up. The area is going to be approximately equal to the sum of these 4 areas, where area sub 1 is going to be f of 2 times 1, again the height times the width, plus area sub 2 will be f of 3 times 1, plus area sub 3 will be f of 4 times 1, and area 4 will be f of 5 times 1. Now I do want to compare this to the left-sided rectangles just for a moment. Notice how we're subbing in 2, 3, 4, and 5 into the function to determine the height of the right-sided rectangles. But going back to the previous video, using left-sided rectangles, we were subbing the x values of 1, 2, 3, and 4 into the function to determine the heights. So I think it's really important that we sketch our rectangles so we know exactly what's happening. So going back to our example now, we'll substitute 2, 3, 4, and 5 into the original function of f of x equals 4 divided by x to determine the height of each of these rectangles. So f of 2 would be 4 divided by 2 times 1. F of 3 would be 4 divided by 3 and then times 1. F of 4 would be 4 over 4 times 1, and f of 5 would be 4 over 5 times 1. So we're going to have 2 plus 4 thirds plus 1 plus 4 fifths. So this comes out to 5 and 2 fifteenths, or if we want this as an improper fraction, it would be 77 fifteenths. So using right-sided rectangles, the approximate area under the function is, let's call it 77 fifteenths square units. And again, notice how this is the lower sum because this area is actually less than the area under the function. So we know the area would actually be more than this, but we also know, going back to the left-sided rectangles, that the area would be less than 25 thirds. So it's going to be somewhere in between those two areas. Next, we'll do the same problem again using left and right sided rectangles, but we'll use 8 rectangles instead of 4. And the idea is the more rectangles we use, the better our approximation would be. To visualize this, we can take a look at a Wolfram demonstration. Here we're using 4 right sided rectangles. And as we increase the number of rectangles, you can see the approximation gets better. So if we took the limit of this sum as n approached infinity, we would actually approach the area under the curve. I hope you found this helpful.